Welcome to the Math Planet, your fast math guide. Hi everyone! Let's learn to tell time. Are you ready? Hey guys, it's Baby Shark. Today we'll learn about analog clocks and digital clocks. In fact, the title of our lesson is Telling Time to 5 Minutes. Let's start with the analog clock. An analog clock is divided into 12 equal parts and it has 3 pointers or hands. The thin hand is for the seconds. The thicker long hand is for the minutes and the shortest hand is for the hours. Next we have the digital clock. The digital clock contains 2 digit numbers. In the clock shown, the leftmost number is for the hours. The middle number is for the minutes and the rightmost number is for the seconds. The valid values for a digital clock are as follows. The hours can take from 1 to 12. The minutes can take numbers from 0 to 59. And the seconds can take numbers from 0 to 59. Why is this? This is because 1 hour has 60 minutes and 1 minute has 60 seconds. This means that the least value to be seen on a digital clock is 100, and the greatest value that you can see on a digital clock is 12:59:59. Let's focus on telling the time in hours and minutes. The hours hand, the shorter one, moves from one number to another in 1 hour. Thus, the hours take values from 1 to 12. The minutes hand, the longer one, moves from one number to another in 5 minutes. So, as you move the minutes hand around the clock to show 1 hour, you need to skip count by 5 for each number that passes. For example, the hours hand now points to 3 and the minutes hand points to 12. So, the time is 3 o'clock. When the minutes hand moves to 1, which is the next number, this means 5 minutes have passed and the time will be 3:05. 5 minutes later it will be 3:10, 5 minutes later it will be 3:15 and so on. So as you move the minutes hand, you need to skip count by 5. Let's continue skip counting. So after 3:15, it will be 3:20. Then 3:25, then 3:30, which is 3:30. Next, it will be 3:35, then 3:40, 3:45, 3:50, 3:55, and when it is 3:60, this means we move to the next hour, so it will be 4 o'clock and we will reset the minutes counting to 0. Now, let's try some practice questions to tell time. Question A. Complete the clocks to show the same time. Number 1. The analog clock is shown and we need to tell the time on the digital clock. The hours hand points to 9 and the minutes hand points to 12. So, the time is 9 o'clock or 9:00. Question 2. The analog clock is shown and we need to find the digital clock. So let's see, the hours hand is between 1 and 2, so it is still 1 o'clock. The minutes hand is at 6, so it is 1:30 or 1:30. Question 3. The hours hand is between 4 and 5, so it's still 4 o'clock. The minutes hand points to 9. So it is 4:45. In number 4, the digital clock is shown and you need to draw the hands for the analog clock. The digital clock shows 7:10. So the hours hand will point to 7 and the minutes hand will point to 2. Question 5. The digital clock shows 2:55. So we'll draw the hours hand between 2 and 3, but it should be closer to 3 because after 5 minutes only, it will be 3 o'clock. and the minute hand will point to 11. Question 6. The digital clock shows 6:15, so we will draw the hour's hand for the analog clock pointing to 6 and the minute hand will point to 3. Now, let's try a different type of questions and try to answer this question. What time will it be? Within some minutes. Number 7, we need to find the time after 5 minutes. Now the time is shown to be 8:40. So after 5 minutes, or in 5 minutes, the time will be 8:45. Question 8. What time will it be after 10 minutes? Now the time is 10:05. So we'll skip counting by 5. Plus 5, 10. So in 10 minutes, it will be 10:15. Question 9. What time will it be after 20 minutes? Now it's 5:10. So let's add 20 minutes. Plus 5, 10, 15, 20. So in 20 minutes, it will be 5:30 or 5:30. Question 10. What time will it be after 35 minutes from now? Now it's 12:25, so let's add 35 minutes. Plus 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and 35. So in 35 minutes, we will move to the next hour, so it will be 1 sharp. To sum up, today we learned about telling time to 5 minutes using both analog and digital clocks. We're done for today's lesson. Thanks for watching the Math Planet. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos. See you next time. Bye!